Now we will be looking at the slow motion video of a starter in action. Now we see that when we switch on the tube light, glow discharge occurs, which heats up the biometallic strip and it touches the other metal contact. Then we have a few very short and bright flashes of light, and then finally the tube light is switched on after many attempts. And then the starter does not make any further attempts, and we see very little glow discharge happening here. Now we see the video again to see what's happening. Now we see that there is little distance between these two, and this bimetallic strip is far from the other metal contact. And then we switch on the tube light, and the 220 volts appears across this, and when the glow discharge happens, everything gets heated up and this bimetallic strip expands to touch this metal contact. So very large current flows through the starter, but for a very short time, and there is only the ballast which is controlling the current at this point. And then as these two strips touch each other, there is no potential difference, and so the glow discharge stops and this bimetallic strip cools down. And when it cools down, the current falls from a very large value to a very small value in a very short period of time, and we get the inductive kick. But the first inductive kick generally does not switch on the tube light, because the filaments simply aren't heated enough, and so we require multiple starts. And each time we see a bright flash, we also have the inductive kick, and finally the inductive kick is able to switch on the tube light.